Good morning, students. Good morning, one and all. Welcome to DCEB Khammam and Suryapet YouTube channel. This is Krishna Priya, PGT Economics, TS Model School and Junior College, Anajpuram Village, Penpahad Mandal, Suryapet District. Before starting the lesson, I would like to thank our DO, Sri P. Madan Mohan sir, for providing me this wonderful platform. It's a golden opportunity for me to share my teaching through online in COVID-19 situation. I also thank one and all who has taken an initiation to create a district YouTube channel for online classes. Thank you. Thank you one and all. So today topic is 9th class social studies, second lesson, the natural realms of the earth, that is lithosphere. So let me share my screen. So as I said earlier, today we are going to discuss about 9th class social studies, second lesson, the natural realms of the earth, that is lithosphere. In this lesson, we are going to achieve the learning objectives. Students able to explain the four different realms of the earth. Students describe about the jigsaw puzzle and the moving plates. Students explain about the slow movements and sudden movements on the lithosphere. Students describe about the external process of the lithosphere. Students interpret how air and water transform the surface of the earth. Students explain the work of water, waves, wind, glaciers on the lithosphere. Students describe the action of vegetation and human beings on earth. So let us recall what we have learned in the previous lesson, that is our earth. So in this lesson, students, you come across through the topic internal structure of the earth. So you have learned that our earth on which we are living is containing three main layers. So it is covered by three main layers, namely crust, mantle, inner core and outer core. So in this particular lesson, we are studying about the topmost layer of the earth, that is crust. It's nothing but the lithosphere. This crust is floating on the upper layer of the mantle surface. So this crust is floating on the mantle. So, in the last class itself, you have learned about continental drift of plates, who proposed by German meteorologist and geophysicist Alfred Wegener. So, this theory can be studied later in the same class under the heading jigsaw puzzle. Okay, children, let us enter into the topic. So the one who studies earth were known as earth scientist. So they proposed there are four great realms on the earth's surface. So they are lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere, and biosphere. So in this topic, we are going to discuss all these realms in brief and about lithosphere in detail. So the first realm of the earth is lithosphere. So the lithosphere is divided into oceanic crust and continental crust. So lithosphere is divided into oceanic crust and continental crust. So the lithosphere is a word derived from Greek words litho, which means stone, spira, which means spear. Lithosphere is the hard shell of the earth consisting of the crust and the topmost part of the upper mantle with an average thickness of 100 kilometers. Further, crust is divided into oceanic crust and continental crust, which includes mountains, plateaus, plains, deep valleys, and also the oceans. It contains the minerals, rocks, and soils that humans use for building materials, making metals, and for agriculture. So the prime functions of the lithosphere are, it supports all the life forms on the earth. It is a rich source of minerals, and these minerals help in making many useful products. So students, can you name any some minerals which are available under the earth? Yes, you are right. So it is a major source of fuel such as coal and petrol, etc. So here you can find some minerals which are available under the earth. So the petroleum is available under the oceanic crust. So let us move with the second realm of the earth, that is hydrosphere. So hydrosphere is a study of water bodies on the earth's surface. So the hydrosphere is the word which is derived from Greek word hydra, which means water. It contains all the solid, liquid, and gaseous water of the plain. So on the surface of the earth, we find water in various forms. It is in solid, so in the form of ice, which is covered on Arctic and on Himalayan mountains. And liquid form, you can find oceans, rivers, ponds, lakes, etc. And in gaseous form, so under atmosphere, we can find some content of vapor which is persisting. So that you can take as gaseous form. So it includes the oceans, seas, lakes, ponds, rivers, and streams. The hydrosphere covers about 70% of the earth and is the home for aquatic life. So, under the ocean, you can see so many varieties of fishes and other creatures. Right, children? So, it is the home for aquatic life. So, there are some water resources found deep in the earth in the gaps between rocks. That is mainly groundwater or mineral water. So, the water bodies, which is not only found on the surface of the earth, but we can also find some of the water which is under the beneath of the rocks, which we call as groundwater or mineral water. So, the third element of the earth, it is atmosphere. Atmosphere is a thin layer of gases which is surrounded around the earth. So, atmosphere is a word derived from Greek word atmos, which means vapor, and spira, which means sphere or ball. Atmosphere is a layer of gases surrounding our planet with oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, water vapor, etc., and also the dust particles. So, in atmosphere, the nitrogen plays a major role. It is about 78%, and oxygen is about 20%, and carbon dioxide is about 0.03%, whereas other gases also found in certain percentages. So, the layers of the earth's atmosphere are divided or subdivided by variations in height, pressure, temperature, electrical properties, and lapse rates. The atmospheric layers include troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and exosphere. So, these layers are subdivided depending on the height, pressure, temperature, electrical properties, and also the lapse rate. So, the fourth most realm of the earth is biosphere. Biosphere is a study of life. So, biosphere is a combination of atmosphere, lithosphere, and hydrosphere. So, biosphere is a word derived from Greek word bio, which means life. Biosphere is composed of all living things, including the small microorganisms on earth and the physical environment that supports them. It is made up of three parts, namely atmosphere, air, hydrosphere, water, and lithosphere, rocks and sediments. So, the four realms of the earth are deeply interrelated and influence each other. So, let us study the first realm of the earth, lithosphere, in detail. So, as I said early, the lithosphere is divided into oceanic crust and continental crust. So, the lithosphere of the earth is not even. It is not even. It is covered with different landscapes like plateaus, mountains, lower plains, deep valleys, lowlands, and glaciers, etc. So, we can find or the landforms on the earth surface. So the oceans and the continents together called as first order landforms. Whereas due to internal process of the earth, they created some mountains, plains, plateaus, oceans, etc., which were called as second order landforms. We have third order landform also. It is created by the external forces like wind, water, glaciers, etc. So let us move to the topic, the jigsaw puzzle and the moving plates. So in the earlier lesson, you come across continental drift theory, which is proposed by Alfred Wagner. So he said that before 200 million years ago, the Earth's surface was found as one landmass and one ocean. So this landmass is named as Pangaea, whereas the ocean is named as Pantalsa. Due to the internal process of the earth, this landmass has been split into two major landmass after 115 million ago. So it is named as Laurasia, which is also called as Angara and Gondwana. So the sea between the two portions of the landmass is known as Tethys Sea. Again, due to the continuous internal process of the earth, these landmasses again splitted into many, and at last today whatever the landmasses we are observing on the earth were situated like this. So these landmasses are floating on the mantle. So actually whatever the surface we are seeing on the earth are called as plates. So these are the plates. You can see the red line. Yes. So these are the plates which are floating on the mantle. So there are seven major plates and some other minor plates on the earth. So the seven major plates are North American plate, South American plate, African plate, Indo-Australian plate, Antarctic plate, Eurasian plate, and the Pacific plate. We have other minor plates like Nazca and Arabian plate. Actually, these plates are floating on the mantle. The earth movements, that is, forces operating inside the earth crust, cause the plates to move away from each other or to move towards each other. So actually, the continents, whichever we are seeing on the earth's surface, were moved away or they are come towards each other due to the movement of plates. So let us have a deep discussion about plate tectonics. So this plate tectonics is a theory which explains about how the pieces of earth surface, that is the plates, move. So the earth crust is broken into several pieces called plates that move over a layer of hot magma in the mantle layer of the earth. So there is a note, children. This theory states that the word tectonic is derived from the Greek word tekton, which means builder, which in turn was derived from Sanskrit word takshan, that is also same meaning, builder. So children, have you never wondered about the different landscapes which we are seeing on the earth surface? Like whenever you used to see the high mountains, the greenery plains, the deep valleys, oceans, volcanoes. Don't you ever wonder about that? How they are created? Who created them? Is that God? No, not at all. So those all land masses like mountains, plateaus, valleys, etc. were made by the earth itself. Yes, you believe it or not, those land masses are created by soul and solely by the earth itself. Are you confused? So let us have a look how they are created. So the plate tectonics, that means the movement of plates, are broadly divided into three types: divergent plates, convergent plates, and transform plates. So the first one we are seeing, divergent plates. If the two plates move away from each other, what happens? If the two plates which move away from each other, can see here in this image, this continental crust is moving towards this way and this plate is moving towards this way. In between, so this is the plate which is floating on the upper layer of the magma, as we learned before. So this magma is pushing up due to the temperatures and pressures under it. It is going to come out with the space that created by the movement of these two plates in opposite direction. Here you can see it is the formation of the rift valley. So here created a valley. So in real image also you can see these plates are moving away from each other. So here you can see the rift valley. And later it is filled with water, that is surrounded seas or oceans. It is filled with water. If these two plates move away from each other, there is a scope for sea floor spreading. Here, the sea is spreading. Yes, children? Now you come to know that. What happens if two plates move away from each other? If two plates move away From each other, there is a creation of rift valleys and also the sea floor spreading. So the other movement of the plates is convergent. What happens if one plate is moving towards this direction and this plate is moving from this direction? That is, they are coming towards each other. These two plates are coming towards each other. So as the plates move and push each other, a lot of pressure is exerted, leading to many changes. Due to huge pressure, one plate gets pushed under into the mantle, whereas the other plate gets pushed up, causing formation of chain of mountains. These movements also cause volcanic eruptions and earthquakes. So in this image, you can see, children, this is the continental crust and this is the oceanic crust. This plate is moving towards this plate. So they are moving towards each other. So you can see it is the static plate. So this, when this plate is moving towards this plate, it is going under into this plate. It is going under, right? So when it is moving towards the undersurface of the earth, here you can see asthenosphere, which is the upper layer of the mantle. Due to the heavy temperatures, this lithosphere melts and in the asthenosphere, and it is going to rise up towards the upper layer of the crust, which leads to volcanic eruption. Here, volcanic eruption is occurring. And here you can find many mountains formed. So the best example we can take, this is the Indo-Australian plate, which is moving towards the Eurasian plate. This is the Eurasian plate and this is the Indian plate. So it is the static plate. When it is moving towards the Eurasian plate, here the chain of mountains formed. Those are the Himalayas, the Great Himalayas. So children, assume that if this process goes continuously, what happens? Yes, here the Indian plate is going to merge with the Eurasian plates. Slowly, it will go under the surface of the Eurasian plates and it melts in the asthenosphere. Slowly, the Indian surface will be changed. Yes, children, what happens if the plates convergent each other? If the plates convergent each other, there is a scope for formation of chain of mountains and also volcanic eruptions. So let us move with the third type of movement of plates, that is transform. If the plates passes through each other in opposite direction, here the plates are passing away each other in opposite direction, it leads to what? See, this is the transform fault. So this plate is moving this word and this plate is moving this words. So there is a scope of this type of landmass. Suddenly what happens if these two plates passes away from each other in opposite direction? It leads to huge losses on the earth in the form of earthquakes. So this is the sudden movement of the earth. So they are passing together in a opposite direction. So it happens suddenly. So you, in the real picture, you can see these are the two plates. These are the two plates. Here, these two plates are passing together in the opposite direction, which leads to earthquakes. Yes, children, do you got what happens if the plates move? So, on the surface of the earth, the plates are moving in three ways: diverging, converging, and transforming. If they diverge, that means if they move away from each other, it leads to creation of rift valleys and also the sea floor spreading. If they convergent each other, that means they are coming towards each other, it leads to chain of mountains and also the volcanic eruptions. If they are transforming, that means they are passing together each other in opposite direction, which leads to huge economical and human loss, that is earthquakes. So all the changes that is occurring on the earth's surface is due to because of movement of plates. So the movements of plates is proposed by the theory plate tectonics. Right, children? So this is the class I end up. I'm assigning you some work depending on the topic that I discussed. So these are your assessment works you have to do. You have to solve all the questions. So the class will be continued in the next class. Thank you.